Hello everyone. Today I'm going live with Vipin Baloni from a great photographer, a very interesting person from Delhi, and we'll chat about his story, his journey in photography and about life. Let's wait for him. Hello, hello. And Satish. Hello.
Hello. Is it fine now?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Can you hear me?
Yeah. Perfect.
So I got in 4G now and I'm in
great.
A hotspot.
Okay.
You can hear me, right?
Right. All good.
So thank you so much for coming in my session. It's
it's my pleasure. It's my pleasure. It's
a pleasure for me also because I found you very interesting, your photographs, your thought process.
Thank you.
Thank you everyone for joining. I am chatting with Vipin Baloni from Delhi. And
true.
I met Vipin Baloni a few weeks back in
yes.
Instagram.
Hmm.
And I found his pictures very interesting. His photography and his thought process is very similar to mine. We both similar.
Exactly.
Think about politics,
So
we'll talk about it.
That's a common ground, yes.
Common ground. So tell us about yourself, about your childhood days, how you were and what you did.
So my name is Vipin Baloni. I'm a photographer, a portrait and documentary photographer from New Delhi. And my work has been featured on the International Center of Photography. I mean, exhibited at International Center of Photography recently. And apart from that, my work has also been featured on various online photo magazines such as Pexels, Viewberg, and Flickr, and so many other magazines as well. And apart from that, I've told you earlier as well, I run an online photography community on Instagram called The Portrait Bazaar. So I started that page 2 years back, and I'm working on that as well. It's going great. And apart from that, I would say I also own a small company with one of my friends. Basically, it's called Free Will Creatives. And it's basically an advertising agency for hospitality industry where we work with different hotels and resorts all over India. And we provide photographs, ad films, and web designing services, web development, and many more. So that's something that I do.
Hotel one?
I started it like 2-3 years back. Yeah, somebody called me, a friend of mine actually, asked me to shoot for this hotel. So I did that. And from there, I, kept on shooting for different hotels. So earlier it was like the work came from some friend of mine. But from then onwards, I started working professionally on that. And finally, we have built a company. And currently, we're looking out for an office as well, because till date, we're working from our home. So we don't have an office, but now we are looking out for an office. Yes, true. That's true.
Home is the best way to start because
that's how
you start and then that's how you grow.
Hmm.
And my brother, he started his office from his home.
Okay, great.
He has like 150 employees.
Wow, amazing.
He owns a company now. Like he's going big. Like every day,
oh,
going
great,
bigger
great.
And bigger. Yeah, that's how you start. Like.
Yeah, that's how I started. Yes.
So tell us something about your photography journey, how it started.
Like it was kind of an experimenting sort of a thing. Earlier when like in my childhood days, I wanted to do so many different things. You know, there was a time when I wanted to be a cricketer. Then I wanted to be a pilot engineer. So it my life has been like full of experiments. And suddenly one day while our family was going through some old photographs that my father took with his old Premier film camera back in his days. So that's when it really dawned on me that, okay, this is something that I can try as well. I've tried so many different things and then why not photography?
When was
so
this?
It was like when I was probably 18 or 19. I'm 26 right now. So yeah, at that time. So that's when I thought that let's experiment with this thing as well. Photography could be a
you started with film.
No, my completely digital. Completely
It was your
digital. It
first
was
camera.
Canon. Canon. I don't know the exact model, but it's a point. It was a point and shoot camera. It was a point and shoot
How
camera. I
you don't
used to just.
remember? You should remember it.
I guess it was 5700 or something. Canon 5700 or something. It was a point and shoot camera. I still have that camera. So at
Golden
that
color?
time, yes.
Silver or golden color?
Exactly. You remember that. So I used to hang around with that camera, and I used to go to like zoo in Delhi, and I used to click animals. And the funny thing is, at that time, I used to think that I'm doing this I don't know what to say. Wildlife
Wildlife,
photography.
wildlife.
I used to think that I'm doing wildlife photography, but later on I realized that that's not wildlife photography at all. Wildlife photography is something when you click animals and their natural habitat. So very lately I realized that, but I used to enjoy that, and I used to go different places with that camera, and that's how
You
it
started
the
taking
interest in
animals,
photography.
and then when did you start taking portraits of men, like human?
After realizing it for like after 1 year that humans can be interesting as well. So I started clicking photographs with that, and it was amazing. And like I said, I used to experiment things a lot. And initially I thought that this would be just an experiment, but later on, slowly and gradually, as I started doing it and I kept on doing it, I found that it's interesting. Okay, I have
How
been
well
a
were you
very in
studying?
I was good. I was quite good. Quite good. I would say I used to be the topper in my class. So
Oh,
I was very good with studies. There was like no problem as far as that department was concerned. But my father always used to think that I'm doing all these things because I want to get away from studies.
that happens with everyone.
That happens with everybody.
So
So
when did you
that's
get
how I.
serious?
What?
When did you get serious about it?
I don't remember exactly the time, but as I was experimenting, and then suddenly I thought that okay, now this is something that I'm loving, because initially, as I told you, it was just an experiment. So I wanted to see if I'm serious about it or not, because earlier there were so many things that I tried and then just left. I was basically an escapist. Okay, suddenly I used to find a problem and I used to just leave that thing and do something else. So my mind was completely like that. So I kept on doing that, but one day I finally realized that okay, this is something that interests me and I can do this for the rest of my life. So that's when I bought a camera. That's when I bought a Canon 1200D camera. That was my first DSLR camera. And
So, what
then
about
it was
job and all? Did you do job?
no, I never, never, never in my life I went for job.
Very good, very good. I like it.
Right from the start, I was very, very much clear about it, that I don't want to get into jobs and all. I always wanted to, do something on my own, whether it is small or big, doesn't matter to me. But I always wanted to do something on my own. So as I was experimenting with photography, I found so many different photographers as well. Narayan, Satish, no job. So I did few internships as well. There were two photographers that I
With whom
interned.
you did?
There's this photographer in Delhi called Gulzar Shetty. He's a wedding photographer. I did internship with him for a
You
few for few
did
yeah.
weddings?
Yes, few of them. And
Ouch.
I hated it
Why?
completely. I don't know, but I hated it. Wedding was
Oh,
not my thing.
I love weddings.
I don't. I hardly go to any
I've
weddings.
done like 20, 25 weddings.
Wow, that's amazing. I think it varies person to person. I'm not, I've been a very introvert sort of a person. So I hate public gatherings and, going to parties and all. I
So
keep
for
myself alone.
how long you did that internship?
For around 8 months or so. It
8 months
was very
you
brief.
just did. Wow.
And then, so my idea for internship was that I wanted to, learn the craft. I wanted to learn how to operate a camera and all that. But when I started that internships, all I was doing was, going around in weddings. So I hated it. Then I started internship with another photographer. His name is Atul Pratap Chauhan. He's a commercial photographer based in Delhi, Saket. So I worked with him as well. But finally, I didn't like the idea of internships and I thought, let's start on my own and I'll find my way on my own. Because I don't want people to, yeah.
What were the challenges you faced when you started?
In photography? Okay, the challenge was, first of all, it was about money. How to earn? Okay, it was like, it was my passion. I wanted to do it and I love it. But there has to be a way, you know, so that I can help myself financially. I can support myself financially as well. So that was the initial problem. But when I started sharing my photographs online with people, there were so many people who loved my work at that time. And that has given me the kind of boost that I needed at that time. So that was something. And to this day, I would say the biggest challenge for me is to, you know, interact with people. I'm not very good with interacting with people. I'm a very introvert sort of a person. I keep myself alone most of the time. So communication is something that has been very tough for me.
But you can communicate with me, huh?
Yeah, I can do that now. Now I can do that. But earlier when I started, communication was very, you know, the important thing for me. I was very bad at communicating with people. So
what
that was the initial.
What was the issue like?
I don't know. I was a very shy kid. And I always used to think that whenever I will go, you know, to people, go talking to people, what will they think of me? And this was the fear. How will they judge me and how will people...
I can relate.
But now I'm... Yeah, but I'm completely comfortable with that. I personally believe that when you're comfortable with yourself, when you're comfortable with your personal reality, that's when everything, you know, goes good. So, yeah. So now it's all good. I can share my perspectives with people. I can hear other people talking as well. It's all good now. All thanks to these books that I've read over the period of time.
Which books you have read?
So many of them, from like, self-help to philosophy, psychology.
Who is your, like, spiritual master?
Spiritual master? No, I don't have
anyone.
I follow Sadhguru. Sadhguru Jaggi Vasudev is somebody that I've been following for a very long time. And there are so many other people as well. Sandeep Maheshwari is somebody that, you hear his name? Heard his name? Okay. He's a photographer as well. He like owner of a company called Images Bazaar. So earlier I used to see so many videos of him. So that's it.
So you learn from YouTube also?
Yes. Basically, yes. YouTube and books and Google and articles on all that.
So
I would say...
You shoot every day?
No. I don't shoot every day. But every now and then, whenever I go outside, I take my camera with me. And like when I go for these hotel shoots in different locations, that's when I shoot my personal images as well for myself that I want to do.
So how you got into hotel? Like what made you shoot hotels?
It happened, you know. I never planned it. Frankly speaking, I never planned it. There was a friend of mine who was like, who used to create websites for different hotels. And one day he suddenly asked me that there is this hotel who want to get their photo shoot done. So why don't you just go and shoot for them? So I did that shoot and they liked the photographs. And that's when, then again, he asked me to, you know, do another shoot for him. And so that's how it started. I never planned that I'll go into hospitality photography and all that, hotel photography. I never planned it. It all happened naturally, organically for me. And when I finally realized that, okay, now I'm shooting hotels continuously, then why not start on my own? Why not start a company alone and, you know, start shooting for hotels? Then a friend of mine joined me and we built this company called Free Will Creatives. And now we do advertising and all sorts of things now.
So
it was completely organic. I never planned.
So which is your favorite project which you have done till now?
Okay. There was this hotel in Kasauli, Himachal Pradesh. I love that project. Really,
Why?
the environment was amazing because the hotel was amazing, frankly, if I have to say. The
What's the
hotel
name?
that it was, it's called, 1 minute, let me check. I forget things very often. It's called Jasmine Cottage.
Jasmine, is it there in Instagram?
Yes. Yes, it is.
Jasmine Cottage. And when was this?
Found
Can you
it?
hear me? Yeah.
Yeah, I can hear you.
5,000 followers.
Oh, I don't know if it this is the hotel or not.
Yeah, Kasauli, Himachal.
Okay, yeah, this is the one then.
Yeah, it looked nice, yeah.
Yes, yes, yes.
So, for how long you did that project?
It was a 2 or 3 day project. We were there in that hotel and we were shooting and we were
And you
creating
stayed
videos for
there
them.
only.
Yes. I stayed there only with one of my friend. Yes.
Did you take the shot? You took the shot. Wow. You took the shot.
Yes. There were other shots as well, so many of them.
So what you like? Like you shoot why you look shoot like what?
Sorry, what? Can
You
you come
like to shoot
again?
wide angle? How like what kind of picture
Yes,
you like?
wide angle I love, in which I can add.
Which lens you use for that?
Well, as far as street photography and all general photography is concerned, I have this kit lens 24-105. I use
And
that lens, yeah, and I have another lens, 50 mm lens, that I use for portraits and street photography mainly.
so
And whenever,
I was about to get a project like this, and
okay.
I don't know, it didn't work out. So
Why?
I don't know. They didn't get back to me.
Okay.
So I really want to do such kind of projects, you know. It's very
It's
interesting
amazing. It's amazing. It's amazing.
because
And one thing that, yeah, please.
you get to
Yeah.
live there, you get to
Exactly. The
Indian
lifestyle is good
culture.
as well, and you get to meet so many different people. You get to go to different places. It's amazing. Travel
So
is something that I love.
if you have any project for me, let me
Sure. Why not? We can do it like together as well.
can collaborate, right?
Sure. I would love to do that.
So, which is who inspires you? What inspires you in life?
In life in general or photography?
In general.
In general, so many people. My dad sometimes inspires me the way he has lived his life. And there are so many people. Earlier it was Steve Jobs used to inspire me a lot when I hear stories about so many different, business or startup people, entrepreneurs. So these were the people that used to inspire me.
Okay.
And anybody who is like doing something in his life on his own or on her own really inspires me. Those stories really inspires me. If somebody is doing something different and that's something that inspires me.
Who's your favorite fashion photographer?
Fashion photographer, I don't like fashion photography at all.
But you like
I very hardly I do fashion projects. I love portrait photography, and if you ask me about my favorite photographer as far as portrait work is concerned, I would say portrait or fashion mix, Peter Lindbergh was somebody that I love. I love
Okay.
Peter Lindbergh, and
Why?
there is this because of his black and white photography and the way he has changed the fashion industry, because his fashion photography was completely different from the way contemporary fashion photography is, which is all about colors and glitters and glamours and all that. And in doing that, I think, you know, we miss the important factor. We miss the important factor. We miss the personality of the person. And the way Peter Lindbergh used to shoot his models, that was amazing. Yeah, that's shot. Yeah, I shot
when
that.
When did you shoot them?
I shot this while we were doing his name is Mayank. He's MJR, called MJR. He's a musician and singer. So we were doing a video shoot for him. I was doing a video shoot for him. So that's when I took that photograph. It was a dance shoot, basically.
You love staged dance shoots, right?
Yes, because there is so much of, you know, drama in it, involved poses and all that. Yes, exactly. That
it's you tell them dance to shoot. Pose, or you just
can't. No, it was completely like she was dancing. I just, yeah. Amazing. I love that shoot, by the way. She, yeah.
So
color.
Who is your favorite dancer?
Hrithik Roshan, I would say. He's a dancer as well.
Do you have any concept in mind that you want to shoot like this, or this happened?
Completely natural. Completely. I never planned for my shoots. Never.
I love this.
Yeah, I really love this as well.
He's a dancer?
Yes, he's a ballet dancer from Delhi.
Wow.
And the girl that you were showing earlier, that she's a Kathak dancer. Professional Kathak dancer from Delhi as well.
Who is this guy?
Same. His name is Narayan Sharma. He's the same one. Ballet dancer.
So have you seen this movie, Ye Ballet?
No.
No?
No. Yes. Same person.
Watch it.
Sure. Same person. I love experimenting with lights as well.
So you shoot in studio or what?
No. Sometimes when, you know, it's a professional shoot for a brand or something, I rent it out, basically. I rent studios.
Where is
it? It was shot in Rishikesh. Rishikesh, yes. It's IDPL hotel, IDPL cottage. Guest house, basically.
We were there. Travel often there?
Rishikesh, yes, quite often.
Why you like?
Quite that? Often. First of all, it's because Uttarakhand is my birthplace, so I love Uttarakhand. Yes, I'm from. I was born in Srinagar. Uttarakhand wala Srinagar.
I got
that. Haan. हाँ बहुत लोगों का लग जाता है ना वेरी ब्रीफ टाइम आई वाज लाइक मे बी वन और टू व्हेन आई शिफ्टेड व्हेन माय फैमिली गॉट शिफ्टेड टू दिल्ली बट दैट ब्लड इज स्टिल इन मी एंड आई लव उत्तराखंड ऋषिकेश इज समथिंग सम इज अ प्लेस दैट आई लव गोइंग देयर एंड आई लव दैट प्लेस
व्हिच इज अ गुड प्लेस टू स्टे देयर
इन ऋषिकेश I stay in, there's a hotel called Hotel Lakshman Jula.
Okay, where is it?
Right in front of the Lakshman Jula.
Don't tell me.
Yeah, it's amazing. Lovely hotel. You get a wind, Ganga view room.
Wait. So, I'm going in April.
Okay.
What is the charge of the room?
Very basic. I mean, 1500 to 15,000 or 2,000. Hotel Lakshman. There are so many other hotels as well. I'll let you know.
What are you typing?
No, I was searching for the hotel. It's called Hotel Surya Lakshman Jula.
Cool. So
right in front of the Lakshman Jula. Yes.
How was your lockdown period?
I would say it was amazing. I got to learn so many different things. And as I told you, the page that I was working on, the Portrait Bazaar, I've been working on that page for like last 2 years. And I wasn't seeing any growth on that page. It was only at the time of lockdown that the page started booming.
Really?
Yeah, and
45,000 followers.
yes,
Wow.
45,000 followers. So
So
earlier,
how did
when the lockdown happened for the first time, the follower count on that page was somewhere around 2,000 or 1,500, 2,000 or 2,500. From the lockdown period, as the lockdown started, the page started growing. I don't know
What?
why. What was the? I
What?
don't know. Yeah, I
Really?
don't know. Yes, I was working continuously on that page for last 2 years, but nothing was happening. But as the lockdown happened, the page started in the followers started coming onto the
So
page.
you curate foreign photographers also.
Yes.
So how much time you give to it?
I would say 1 hour or 2 hour a day.
Like every time, or
Yes, every day. Every
initially
day.
you gave
No, initially I used to give a lot of time, but it was kind of frustrating. Yes, it's amazing.
Wow, this is wow. This is like Andy
The name of
Lack's
the photographer.
Twitter. So yeah, this is a great page. I would
Yes,
say
and I would say I've learned so many things from that page, because
what
there
have
are
you learned?
so many photographers from all around the world, and quite often I do live sessions on that page as well. So the way I talk to other photographers, and they tell me so many different perspectives and things about their work. So there is so much to learn from, all the photographers out there.
So what have you learned?
So many things, so many things. The way they see photography, the way, because my way of working, my way of shooting things is completely different. So I get to see so many different perspectives, how people shoot and what they think of photography. When I do live sessions, I get to talk to so many different photographers, and the sheer perspective that they bring onto the board, it's amazing. How they work and the procedure that they work in, quite amazing.
We are on the same boat. We are
Yes,
doing
true.
pages and it's going very
Yes.
well. And
You
we
also
can
have a page. You also have a page, but I forget the name. Collective or something.
How can you forget?
I'm very bad with remembering things.
Hardcore sheet collector.
Yes. Yes. I
So
remember.
I have a
Please.
live session today with them. So, what is the plan for Portrait Bazaar now? What is the
Plan, I
goal?
would say
Do you have any agenda?
I'm waiting for the page to hit 50K first of all, and then I'll be doing few photography competitions. We'll execute some of them, photography competitions and all, and I'll take it from forward from for there from for there.
Why you like photography competitions?
Photography competition, it just gives a chance to you to share your work with people, and if you get a prize, if you won something, it's good. It feels good, because when I started, I wanted that to happen with me.
I hate competitions.
And you hate competitions?
I
Why?
hate. I
Why?
just
Why?
it creates a lot of anxiety and I don't find it genuine.
Okay.
So a
I
lot
can
of
understand,
competitions
yes.
are very political driven. They
True, true,
choose
true. That happens.
already
Yes.
that who
Yeah,
won
yeah,
the.
yeah.
That's what I mean. And not many, not everyone, like most of, like that's
That's
why
true, that's
I don't
true.
go for competitions.
Competitions, yes. I can understand that,
I
yes.
feel workshops and these kind of things are much better.
Workshops and collaborating with others and
Collaborating with
things
others,
like this.
yeah, learn from
Yes.
others, learn or teach.
Yeah, true, true.
So we also have a lot of plans for Hardcore Sheet Collective, like to do workshops once the border opens and exhibitions. That's more important than competition because it's not like that. I'll be partial to anyone, but there is Miami festival which happens. That is very genuine. Like, but I don't know. I don't feel comfortable with competition somehow.
Okay, I can understand that, yes. So what was the idea when you started that page?
So I love
Let me
street
ask you one
photography.
question, is it? Okay.
I love street photography, and I wanted to
Same.
highlight street photography in my India. Like, India
Hmm.
doesn't have much collectibles, like
Yes, please.
international. So I wanted to start that. I gave a lot of time to it, like 4 or 5 hours every day, and used to work on it initially. And I really worked hard for it. Like. And every month, there's 10,000, 10,000 ads. Every month, like I
Amazing.
don't know why, but
Yeah.
people like the curation, and and
Sometimes
it's
sometimes I guess it gets hard to, make other people understand that. So many people ask how you are increasing your followers and how much people are, but what can
genuine,
we
huh?
say? It's all genuine, it's all organic. Yes.
It's all organic, and we don't never sponsor
Yeah.
any.
Yeah. And it's
I want
all
to tell you,
organic. I guess it's all organic. That's why we can't give one answer.
it's all organic, and it's all done with heart, and it's very genuine, and we don't buy followers or whatever we have. It's all genuine, and so
Earlier when I started that page, I used to, Google sometimes how to increase followers. What is the way? But I've
I
done
heard
so
it.
many things. I've done so many things, but I've failed. I failed. And then at last I understood the fact that the only way to increase your followers and people, is to just keep on working on the page continuously.
I never bothered to increase followers. I
Okay.
never bothered.
That's
I just
amazing. That's amazing.
kept walking, and I was always focused, and I was always active. You have to keep your story active, engaging. We have to keep your
True,
feeds
true,
active. Sometimes we used
true.
to post 5 days, 5 days, 5 posts a day. Then initially, used to post 5 posts a day. Then we decreased four, then three, then two. Now it's like one or two.
Okay.
That's how we
And
work.
I learned it way too, like मैं बहुत बाद में सीखा इस चीज को.
And the most
What?
important, when you share someone's post, like picture, always tag in the story. Why?
Yes.
Ask me why.
Why?
So that they can share it back.
Just by one click.
They can share it back, right? And
हाँ
then
हाँ यार
that's
राइट
going
राइट.
to go to more people. That hardcore has featured that. That's the funda
Amazing.
I have learned from one of my friend. She has 100,000 followers on
Wow.
her page, and she had a live session how to do Instagram. Like, I heard this one line,
Okay.
and just tag.
Tag people.
Tagging is very, very important. Very important.
True.
Because everybody likes their picture to get credit in every way. Story,
That's true.
feed, and in the tag post, like. So tagging is most important thing in Instagram.
Right.
And keep having live sessions. Keep having engaging sessions, Questions, ask questions in stories.
It's really important, yes. Use
What do you
hashtag
say?
rich.
What does it mean?
What? Use
Use
hashtag
hashtag.
in which less post
Can you
presents.
elaborate this, please? Photo
I think
hashtag.
the guy is saying to use those hashtags in which the traffic is less.
I'm not tagging of the hashtag. I'm talking of tagging people. Like,
Yeah.
whoever is there, just tag them in
Tag them,
story.
yes, right.
Tag them in the story so that they can share it, right?
They can share it and yeah.
And then you get your reach. Like, I show you how I do. So I go to my page. I go to this page, Hardcore Street Collective. Yeah, how many followers I have? 47.
Wow.
So I tag, right? I tag That's very important.
I've seen on that page, and I've seen like on your personal profile as well. You tag people. It's
tagging
amazing.
Tagging is very important. Like
very important.
You tag if you like someone. Like if you like, if you are very, you know, if you are a fan of someone, like Monica Dongra.
Hmm.
I will tag her, and she tagged me back.
Yes.
Kidding me.
Yes. I understand.
They get to know that I have followed her and I am seeing her work and I tag her. So she tagged me back.
And basically that's called engaging.
Engaging.
That is called engaging. You have to engage with people.
Yeah.
It's not that you share your work and then, you know, think that people will come and like your work and this and no. It works both ways. You have to work both ways.
So you have to give credit.
You have to give credit. You have to engage with other people's work as well.
If you're sharing someone's work, you have to tag them. Otherwise, how will they know that you are sharing their work?
Yeah, yeah. True. Mm-hmm. That's true.
So that's the fun of Instagram. Yeah.
Amazing.
So the more you see stories, the more you get stories. Algorithm, you know how.
Yeah,
like that.
बहुत पढ़ा एल्गोरिथम के बारे में
तो हैशटैग माय पेज हैज द हाईएस्ट हैशटैग यू विल सी
हाउ मेनी
सिक्स एट थ्री के कैन यू इमेजिन दैट
683,000 अमेजिंग
So people tag like crazy, you know.
Hmm.
This is a tag.
Beautiful.
Yeah. So you get to see a lot of good work because of hashtag. Yeah.
Yes.
Hashtag is important. Tagging is important. So tell me, what did you learn in life after Corona?
That you can work from home as well. You don't have to go to office. You don't have to go to office. You can work from home and like and other. What?
That's the only thing you have learned or anything else?
Yeah, so many things. One is like you need less thing to live your life peacefully. Earlier, I used to think that we have to party and we have to, you know, keep on buying things and keep on doing things. But after lockdown, I realized that you can live your life peacefully by, you know, not buying anything or not going outside. You can live your life. There are so less things that we need to live our life peacefully.
Like what? Do you think money is important?
Very important. Money is important. Yes. To a extent, I would say money is important to run your life, in a better way. But money is not the most important thing, I would say.
What is the most important thing?
Your freedom. I believe freedom is something that, like, the most important thing. Money is important to some extent, yes. It is.
So, you have shared few amazing books to read in 2021. So, you have read all the books?
Some of them, yes. Some of them I started and then... फिर मैंने छोड़ दी यस
एक्सट्रीम ओनरशिप सेल्फ रिलायंस अ वे ऑफ डिस्कवरी ऑफ द अनकॉन्शियस 1984 व्हिच इज योर फेवरेट
बुक अमंगस्ट दिस
नो
दिस इज इन जनरल लेट मी जस्ट शो यू दिस इज माय ऑल टाइम फेवरेट बुक मैन सर्च फॉर मीनिंग बाय विक्टर फ्रैंकल ऑल टाइम फेवरेट बुक
बाय
this book, my teacher, my mentor, you know, gave this book to me. I was going through a very tough time. I was sad. I was kind of depressed. So he gave this book to me and he told me that just read this book. And after you finish this book, then come to me and then say that your life is difficult. And after reading this book, I realized that my life is very beautiful. Life is very beautiful in general. We create, you know, difficulties inside our minds. The hardships that the person in this book has to go through was hell. So in comparison to that, our life is wonderful. So I would say this is like my all-time favorite book, and I would recommend it to everybody.
So do you
Yes.
think reading can change your mind?
For sure, for sure.
But
First
not
of all, first of all, not 100%, yes, because ultimately you have to do things on your own. You have to implement those things. Just by reading books, you can't change anything. But for sure, books gives you so many different perspectives. It gives you perspectives of, the writer's perspective and so many different things. And then you can, if you implement them correctly in your life, only actions can give you the final results. Yeah. Yes.
Action, like what kind of action?
What?
What kind of action is needed?
Actions, I mean actions that are directed towards your goal. Because like for instance, if you read a book and you learn something from that book, but until and unless you put those things into action in your own life, until and unless you do things on your own, nothing will change in your life. There are so many people who read books, but they're still same because they don't implement the things that they learned from that book. So implementing is of the highest priority, I would say. Yeah.
So
Reading is good. What?
you have gone through depression?
Yes. Yes.
When?
I don't know if I can call it depression, anxiety or whatever, but it was kind of bad.
When was this?
3 4 years back,
So how you
I was like
managed?
21, 22. By reading books, by watching good videos on YouTube, by hanging around with good people who can understand me, because I feel that the world is going full pace now. Nobody wants to stop for anybody else. And there are very hardly few people who really want to listen to you. So there's my teacher of mine, Deepak sir. He is somebody who helped me a lot. So basically he's into psychology, and he do these psychotherapy things as well. Therapies. So he helped me a lot.
Very important. You have to open up with someone who can.
Yes. You have to find one person in front of whom you can open yourself up
Who
completely.
doesn't judge you? Who doesn't just listen to you? Yeah? Can you hear me?
What? What? Yeah, I can hear you. What?
Who doesn't judge you or you just
Yes,
listen?
yes. Yeah. Who just listens to your whatever you have to say, and that's it. Because sometimes just speaking out is more than enough to, cope up with things. We take so many things, we keep so many things on our inside our mind. We don't share it with other people, and that's when I think the real problem starts. When you keep things onto your own.
So you have written, never aspire to become understood by everybody, as those who understand us enslave something. What do you mean by
True.
that?
By that, I mean when somebody know you completely, inside out, that's when the other people can enslave you, because now they know everything about you. They know about your likings and dislikings, and you never know if the other person is being authentic to you or he's just pretending because now he knows everything about you. So there is this vulnerability that you have to learn with time, that in front of whom you need to, yeah.
Have
So
gone through this. I can
yes,
relate to
yes.
this 100%, what you're saying. Yeah.
Yes.
And they can,
Yeah.
use you, they can
You,
use.
yeah, completely. They can use you for their own good because now they know what triggers you, what makes you sad, what makes you happy. So basically they have the trigger point. Now they can do whatever they want to do with you, and you don't have the slightest of idea what somebody else is doing and why he's doing that. Is he being authentic? Is he really careful for us? You don't know.
So I read something very recently that if somebody is giving love to you, oh, मैंने तुम्हारे लिए इतना कुछ किया,
हाँ
तुमने क्या
हाँ
किया, एंड दिस इज लाइक अ अरे तुम अपने बारे में, उसके बारे में नहीं सोच रहे हो, अपने बारे में सोच रहे हो कि मैंने तो इतना कुछ दे दिया, तुम कॉन्ट्रैक्ट साइन किया है
क्या? हाँ, बिल्कुल बिल्कुल।
कि कोई कॉन्ट्रैक्ट साइन किया है कि तुम जो बोलोगे वही मैं करूँ,
हाँ एग्जैक्टली। ब्यूटीफुल
सो
लाइन।
यू हैव रिटन, प्यार छोड़ो मुझसे नफरत करो, मुझे मारो और मेरे मरने की दुआ करो, मैं जानवर हूँ इंसान की भेष में, मुझसे डरो और मुझसे खुद से दूर करो।
मुझे
व्हाट
खुद
डज
से दूर करो।
व्हाट इज दिस लाइक रिलेटेड टू व्हाट?
आई डोंट नो, आई वाज फीलिंग बैड दैट डे। और ये पोइट्री है, ये बड़ी पोइट्री है, मैंने इसको
हाँ,
चार लाइनें शायद शेयर की।
लेनी शेयर की और करूंगी फ्रेज में।
हाँ, तो बस ऐसे ही बैठा हुआ था, कुछ ना कुछ दिमाग में चल रहा था। मैंने आई थॉट कि मैं दूसरे के पर्सपेक्टिव से सोचने की कोशिश करूं कि मैं अपने आप को कैसे देखूंगा।
प्लीज कन्वर्ट इनटू इंग्लिश।
श्योर, आई विल डू दैट। तो बस ऐसा ही था, मतलब थोड़ा बुरा सा फील हो रहा था किसी दिन।
इंग्लिश
इंग्लिश? ओके ओके, लेट मी जस्ट, हाँ लिखा हुआ है, प्यार छोड़ो मुझसे नफरत करो, डोंट लव मी हेट मी, मुझे मारो और मेरे मरने की दुआ करो, हिट मी एंड प्रे, आगे क्या होगा, मुझे मेरे मरने की दुआ करो, प्रे फॉर माई डेथ, इज इट गुड, मैं जानवर हूं इंसान के भेस में, आई एम एन एनिमल डिस्गाइज, आई एम एन एनिमल डिस्गाइज एज ए ह्यूमन बींग, मुझसे डरो, फियर मी, और मुझे खुद से दूर करो, एंड कीप माई सेल्फ अवे फ्रॉम यू, अदरवाइज अदरवाइज आई कैन हार्म यू, आई एम एन एनिमल, सोशल एनिमल। हाँ
जाने दो मुझे तबाही के आलम में कहीं, और मेरी
इल्तजा,
मंजूर करो,
इल्तजा इज कॉल्ड प्रेयर।
मेरा दुश्मन जमाना नहीं है, मैं खुद का काफी सही, मुझे मेरी ही दुनिया में कहीं दफन करो। आई लाइक इट।
प्लीज कीप ऑन रीडिंग दैट।
ये जो यादें बातें मुलाकातें बसी हैं दिमाग में मेरे, इन्हें खींचो और बाहर मेरे दिमाग में से करो। नींद के साथ जो साज छूट चुका है मेरा, मुझे नशा दो और होश से बेहोशी में मदहोश करो। सो जाओ और सो जाने दो मुझे भी, थक गया हूँ बहुत, थोड़ा मुझ पर भी रहम करो। प्यार छोड़ो मुझसे नफरत करो, मुझे मारो और मेरे मरने की दुआ करो। वाह,
सो बेसिकली इट्स लाइक डोंट लव मी, इफ यू आर प्रिटेंडिंग डोंट लव मी, इंस्टेड यू जस्ट हिट मी एंड रन अवे फ्रॉम मी, बट प्लीज बी ऑथेंटिक इन फ्रंट ऑफ मी।
लाइक इट।
यस, दैट वॉज द क्रक्स।
दैट इज द क्रक्स ऑफ।
यस, दैट वॉज द क्रक्स, दैट्स द क्रक्स ऑफ द होल पोइट्री।
You love to write, and true art comes from flying with the madness so close you burn your eyelashes.
That was not my line.
I know that, but you
Yeah,
have
yeah, yeah.
said, so I want to
Yeah,
ask,
yeah, yeah.
what do you mean by that?
Can you please read that again?
True art comes from flying with the madness so close you burn your eyelashes.
It basically means true art comes when you are on the edge. When you're on the edge, where you are very much vulnerable, where you know exactly that it can harm you. And from there you are creating something for yourself, just from that edge. When you have vulnerability and when you can die.
Right. So I'm there in your story highlight. If you
Sure.
think you can convince people to change their perspective about something, then you are but a fool. The world has completely polarized now, and you simply can't talk with people now on common ground. So
True.
now is the time when, instead of fighting with people, you should opt out of it and just concentrate on some productive work. Very good.
Thank you.
Yes, for pastime you can entertain people. And pick fights with others, but you simply can't convince them about anything. It's a waste of time. Yes.
True. I completely feel that. What?
Our thoughts are very similar.
Yeah, true.
Same shit, you know.
That's true. I feel that. And I think it's artist, true. It's true. Yeah, true. And it's completely true to some sense that you can't convince people now. The way I see people now, the way I see the world now, especially India, I see that we are dividing into two opposite, you know, poles. World is completely polarized. You believe in one thing, I believe in one thing. You can't convince me of your thing, I can't convince you of your thing. Because people don't want to find that neutral ground where we can, you know, have a dialogue, where we can have a conversation about something in a productive way. Very hardly people try and do that.
Right.
Because I have had so many fights with people, especially my friends, over politics and so many different things. But now I finally realize there is no point in doing that. Just if you believe something, okay.
With anyone. No point in fighting. Just.
Yeah, that's true. एक कान से निकाल दिया बिल्कुल एग्जैक्टली
रात तक जाग कर काम करने का भी अभी
अपना अलग ही
हाय होता है बस बैकग्राउंड में पुराना गाना चलते
हैं एडिटिंग का काम करते टाइम पे पुराने पुराने गाने सुनता रहता हूँ मैं मजा आता है
तो मेरे जैसे ही हो
यार
देयर इज नो सच थिंग एज कंप्लीट
Nihilism.
Nihilism. What does it mean?
It means it's a philosophical term. It's called nihilism is something when a person believes that there is no literal meaning of life. Life is meaningless. That's called nihilism. It's a part of philosophy.
Nihilist would kill himself. One of the biggest question that arises when being a nihilist is that. If nothing is permanent and life has no meaning, then why to live? And one can never live rest of his life with this question unresolved in a lifetime. You have find something after which there will be no need of finding anything else. You have to connect to that after which you will have to need no need to connect with anybody else. Right? So right.
Mm.
If you connect to yourself, you don't need to connect with others.
Yeah. Happy on your own. Because I think we all, yeah, true.
Yeah. So you have done like long-term things. We suffer more often in imagination than in reality. What upsets people is not things themselves, but their judgment about the things, right? Emotions are a combination of two elements, an effective movement within the body and judgment. Suffering arises when we attach judgments to these effective movements that are beyond our control. For example, to love someone is within your control. To judgment that this love should be returned and should be so forever is not in your control.
Not in their control. Yeah, I was reading this writer called Seneca. The starting lines of this paragraph was from Seneca, that you suffer more in reality than So I formulated that on my own words then.
Suffer in imagination, not reality.
Yes.
उस पहाड़ से भी रिश्ता मना मानो ऐसा बना हुआ था कि वो बिना कुछ कहे कि मेरे अंदर भावनाओं की असीम लहर उठाकर पानी को मेरी आंखों के रास्ते निकाल बाहर फेंक सकता था बिना कुछ कहे बिना कुछ किए
What was it about? Let's say you are sitting in front of a huge mountain. Mountain is not doing anything to you. It's all in your mind. Whatever that has gone through in your life, you go through that in your mind and you see that mountain, and so many different emotions comes to your mind, and people share those emotions and say that mountain is doing something. So it was about kind of that. कि एक ऐसा ऐसी या ऐसी चीज जो कि बिल्कुल स्टिल है वो भी हमारे अंदर इतना सब कुछ बना देती है, हम सोचने पे मजबूर हो जाते हैं.
मेरे नेचर उस दृश्य की तलाश में नहीं निहित है जिसमें पहुंचकर वह चित्र पूरा हो जाएगा, बल्कि असल में मेरा पूरा चलना एक चित्र का बनना है जिसका कोई अंत नहीं है, जैसे इस चित्र की कोई शुरुआत नहीं थी. तो मेरा चित्र उस जिस दिन खत्म होगा उसे देखने के लिए मैं वहां नहीं होऊंगा. मुझे बहुत बाद में पता चला. वाह,
है ना, ये बुक थी मानव कॉल की, वो पढ़ रहा था उसका अंदर का.
मानव कॉल इज माय फेवरेट. ही हैज रिटन अ बुक.
ही हैज रिटन सो मेनी बुक्स. आई हैव लाइक 4-5 बुक्स ऑफ हिम.
दिस गाय इज सो टैलेंटेड यार.
दैट्स ट्रू. He's a writer, actor, stage artist.
Brilliant actor.
Brilliant.
I got connected to a very good artist because of Manav Kaul.
Okay.
And I did a section. And that section you should watch. It's so sure. Nice. It's full in Hindi.
With whom?
Veena Dubey.
Okay, sure, sure.
Matlab chhodna mat. Matlab wo bandi kya simple hai.
किसी ने लिखा है बहुत अच्छी लाइन. मैंने खो देने को छोड़ देने से पकड़ा.
वाह, मैंने खो देने को छोड़ देने से पकड़ा. मैंने खो देने को. कैन यू एलैबोरेट सर?
मैं समझ पा रहा हूँ.
क्या समझे?
खो देने को मतलब खोने के डर को मैंने अपने आप से ही वो कर लिया, कि छोड़ देने से समझ लिया.
छोड़ देने शायद से.
मैं ऐसा अज्यूम कर रहा हूँ, वो बताएंगे कि ऐसा है कि नहीं.
सो when you have made peace with your subjective truth, then you stop running after people, making them believe in your own version of the truth. Everybody's life is different in so many different ways. Instead of searching for the objective universal truth, rather we should try to find our own little subjective truth. And the realization of your subjective truth is more than enough to ground yourself strongly.
Thank you.
This is so true, yaar. So true. मतलब मजा ही आ गया आज तो.
मतलब बहुत सोचा मैंने. मैं बहुत टाइम तक यही ढूंढता रहा. जिसके पास भी मैं जाता था ना हेल्प मांगने के लिए, बात करने के लिए, आई ऑलवेज यूज टू आस्क देम कि व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ लाइफ, टेल मी वन थिंग दैट वी ऑल आर आफ्टर. बट लॉन्ग आफ्टर अ लॉन्ग टाइम एंड आई फाउंड आउट दैट अपने आप. हाँ, कोई नहीं बता सकता. कोई एक ऑब्जेक्टिव ट्रूथ किसी का नहीं है. गौतम बुद्ध का अपना एक सब्जेक्टिव ट्रूथ था जो उन्होंने रियलाइज किया.
सबकी अपनी जर्नी है.
अपनी जर्नी है. दैट्स ट्रू.
और हाउ यू गो टू दैट जर्नी इज वेरी पर्सनल.
ट्रू.
नोबडी कैन टेल यू, गाइड यू, नो, यू योरसेल्फ हैव टू
गाइड. ट्रू.
यू हैव एनी हार्ट ब्रेक?
One of them, yes.
The heartbreak can teach you a lot.
That's true. I'm still heartbroken.
I think heartbreaks होने चाहिए life.
बिल्कुल.
दुनिया का पता चलता है. अगर आप challenge face नहीं करोगे, you will not learn anything. So everyone.
Well, I frankly think that heartbreaks are like कि आप नींद से उठ जाते हो.
और उनको bless करो, जो भी those who are.
बिल्कुल.
You know. Just bless them because they are giving me a lesson in life.
A lesson in life, yes. About life.
Very important to get.
They have taught you so many things.
They are more important than your friends. Enemy is more important than your friend.
That's true. That's true. That's true. And
like
because
what?
your enemy will tell you so many different things about you that your friend will never tell. Because sometimes it happens that your friends will only say good things about you because they don't want to hurt you.
यही बोलने वाली थी, फ्रेंड विल ओनली से
है
गुड थिंग्स
ना?
अबाउट यू।
हाँ,
अरे
इट्स
तुम तो
गुड.
बहुत अच्छे हो, तुम तो बहुत
हाँ,
बढ़िया।
हाउ इज दिस फोटोग्राफ? दिस इज गुड. अच्छा काम है. बट द पीपल हु क्रिटिसाइज यू, द पीपल हु हेट यू, दोज आर वेरी ट्रू. दोज आर वेरी फोकस्ड ऑन सीइंग कि आपका वो क्या है नेगेटिव एस्पेक्ट. दे'ल टेल यू मोर अबाउट योर सेल्फ.
व्हेन इज द बर्थडे?
इट्स 18 सितंबर.
मेरे को लगा एरीज है क्या?
क्या चीज? हाँ शायद. हाँ
नहीं, आई थॉट इट्स अप्रैल। व्हाट? माय माय
ना
माय
ना 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 ना, मैं एक्वेरियस हूँ. हम एक्वेरियस.
यू नो, मेरा एक्वेरियस से बहुत जमता है, मतलब
अच्छा
ज्यादा ही
वाह.
जमता है। मतलब वी हैव अ कनेक्शन विद इट।
श्योर श्योर, मुझे भी
ऐसा नहीं
लगता
है
है.
कि भी ऐसा नहीं होता है, पता है
हाँ,
एवरीथिंग।
मैं भी, आई टोटली बिलीव इन दैट. नथिंग हैपन्स फॉर लाइक कोइंसिडेंस. मैं नहीं बिलीव करता.
जो भी तुम्हारी लाइफ में आता है, देयर इज अ रीजन बिहाइंड इट।
दैट्स ट्रू.
एवरीवन एंड
एवरीवन
एनीवन
एवरीवन यस.
हू एवर कम्स,
या सम पीपल कम टू यू नो टीच यू समथिंग, और सम पीपल कम सो दैट यू कैन टीच समथिंग टू देम. ईदर वे इट्स गुड.
लाइफ इज वेरी वेरी पजल। लाइफ इज अ पजल।
लाइफ इज अ पजल.
नाउ सॉल्व दैट पजल जब तक हम लोग हैं, एंड जस्ट
एंड
लिव इन द
आई पर्सनली थिंक दैट इट्स द फन इज नॉट अबाउट सॉल्विंग द पजल, इट्स अबाउट कीप ऑन वर्किंग. द प्रोसेस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट. अब किसका पजल सुलझा हुआ है वो तो कौन देखेगा, बट ये है कि द प्रोसेस इज अमेजिंग.
दिनेश खन्ना जी आए थे, उन्होंने सेम थिंग यही बोली। यू हैव टू लव द प्रोसेस, गो विद द प्रोसेस, डोंट जस्ट फोकस ऑन द रिजल्ट। रिजल्ट विल हैपन हाउ एवर इट वॉन्ट्स टू, बट
ट्रू.
प्रोसेस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। सो आई एम डूइंग दिस प्रोजेक्ट 365 वेयर आई एम लविंग द प्रोसेस। आई एम नॉट
ट्रू.
फोकसिंग ऑन द रिजल्ट।
सो हाउ इज दैट प्रोजेक्ट गोइंग?
Outstanding.
वाओ.
Outstanding. I am very happy because of that person.
That's great.
It gives me वो नशा होता है ना, नशा
हाँ
करने के लिए कहाँ कहाँ जाते हैं ना, भटकते हैं पीने के
बिल्कुल
लिए,
बिल्कुल.
नशा वीट का करते हैं, बहुत कुछ करते हैं। बट मेरे लिए नशा, मेरा प्रोजेक्ट 365 है, वेर
वाह.
आई गो हाई, आई जस्ट एंजॉय। लाइक मैं ना ज्यादा शूट भी नहीं करती, 10 फोटो 15 फोटो से ज्यादा नहीं, बट आई एम एंजॉयिंग दैट मोमेंट।
वाह. एंड दैट इज इम्पोर्टेंट. दैट इज इम्पोर्टेंट.
आई एम एंजॉयिंग दैट टाइम ऑफ 3 आवर्स वेयर आई शूट। आई डोंट थिंकर, अरे मेरे को शॉट नहीं मिला, आई डिडंट गेट द शॉट, आई डिडंट फाइंड गुड पिक्चर। आई डोंट थिंक अबाउट दैट। आई जस्ट enjoy, I just relax, I'm just enjoying people around me.
Lose yourself in the process.
I feel everyone should do Project 365 because it makes you very very observant. You grow as a person, you observe, like how, like every time you're observing more, and observing is very important than clicking,
Yes, true, true, true.
very important.
Very important.
What you observe, किसी के लिए भी, तुम्हारे लिए भी बोल सकती हूँ, के लिए बोल रहे। ऑब्जर्विंग से ना तुम्हारी पर्सपेक्टिव ग्रो होती है, कॉम्पोजिशन अच्छा होता है, सब सब।
True.
एंड यू गेट टू मीट पीपल, गेट टू कनेक्ट पीपल। सो या,
True, true. Amazing.
और बताओ, और क्या शेयर करना चाहते हो?
बस, और तो क्या है, बस यही है.
What do you want to do?
किताबें, पोइट्री.
Just into Instagram, just to get famous.
सॉरी, आई डिडंट हेयर योर क्वेश्चन.
बहुत लोग Instagram में आते हैं फेमस बनने के लिए, उसके लिए क्या बोलोगे?
हाँ, मैं तो कुछ भी नहीं बोलूंगा. फेमस होना आई डोंट थिंक इट्स इम्पोर्टेंट. आई वुड से रादर देन बिकमिंग फेमस यू शुड वर्क ऑन इम्प्रूविंग योर सेल्फ एंड कीप शेयरिंग योर वर्क. दैट इज इम्पोर्टेंट बिकॉज एनीबडी एंड एवरीबडी इज फेमस दीज डेज. यू डोंट हैव टू डू मच. जस्ट कम ऑनलाइन स्टार्ट अब्यूजिंग पीपल एंड सडनली यू आर फेमस. सो फेमस आई डोंट थिंक. That those days were gone when a person used to become famous by doing great things. Now this is not the time. Now it's like you do any rubbish thing and you are famous. Big boss will call you.
Like Rahul Gandhi.
In a way.
Rahul Gandhi. Like
मुझे भी लगता है.
हाँ
हाँ बिल्कुल बिल्कुल. एवरी फूल बिलीव्स दैट ही नोज एवरीथिंग. ही हैज गॉट ऑल द आंसर्स.
मतलब ही थिंक्स दैट ही कैन से एनीथिंग टू मोदी एंड आई नो.
आई मीन इट्स
गोइंग डाउन.
या या टोटली totally they're going down. And I stop. And as far as politics is concerned, I strongly believe that criticizing is important. It is important, of course, but the problem starts when you start criticizing people just for the sake of criticizing.
Narayan,
you don't have any
like Rahul Gandhi. In what
it's good
like, please tell me. He made a fool of himself in IIT. People will laugh.
Aspired to become the Prime Minister of India. And the kind of foolish things that he's doing all over the country is hilarious.
So what do you think, other than Modi, who can be the good Prime Minister? Other than Modi, not Modi.
Hmm. Yeah. As far as BJP is concerned, I think Smriti Irani is somebody that I think can be. And one person.
Don't talk about BJP. People.
Sure. But as far as Congress is concerned, there's only one person that I used to like, and I still like the guy, Shashi Tharoor.
Murderer.
I don't know murderer or not, but I like him for the intellectual.
वैसे मैं ज्यादा नहीं बोलूंगी, मेरे को शायद कोई जेल में डाल दे.
हाँ हाँ बिल्कुल बिल्कुल. आजकल तो
एनीथिंग इज पॉसिबल.
या श्योर. नो पॉलिटिक्स.
या इट्स वेरी डेंजरस यू नो. सो लॉट ऑफ पीपल गॉट अरेस्टेड बिकॉज़ ऑफ दैट.
नो पॉलिटिक्स इट्स गुड. आई मीन वी नीड टू टॉक अबाउट थिंग्स बट इन अ पॉजिटिव वे. इफ यू हैव समथिंग गुड टू शेयर यू हैव टू शेयर इट.
So I have to edit this
video now. Sure.
Because I called someone murderer. So.
Sure.
Yeah, it's very dangerous.
Hmm.
How people take it, you don't know.
You don't know.
You That's can't,
true.
You can't say anything for anyone. You don't know who has gone through what.
That's true.
Yeah, Shashi Tharoor is a good personality. He's a good speaker. He's a good orator, writer. But I don't know. What about other? Acha, politics ki to baat kar liye.
Politics kar nahi sakte na.
Logon ne mana kar diya. Log ja rahe hain bhai. 5 people ho gaye. Chalo, theek hai. Bahut maza aaya, Vipin. Bahut acha laga.
Same here. It was lovely talking to you.
We are connected.
And I would say. Sure. And thank you so much for like giving me this opportunity to, you know, talk to you. Really amazing.
Thank you so much.
Very good.
मुझे भी काफी कुछ जानने को मिला लाइफ के बारे में. Thank you. Life more important than photography and making money.
That's true. I totally believe that photography is a very small part of life. You know, it's not all.
So it's very important to talk about more things than just photography. That's why I take up session. you know, about depression, about a lot of other issues. I want to get more people like who have gone through depression and who have gone and just survived from that. If you know anyone,
sure.
If you know anyone who has survived depression, like the bad depression, and I want to take their interview. And it's very important to talk about it. People don't talk about it. And it's sad that they don't talk about it. They think
that's true.
Mental crack ho gaya
hai. Mental crack ho gaya.
Matlab unko lagta hai ki ye koi bahut gambhir bimari hai jisme log pagal ho jate hain. Aisa nahi hai.
Haan.
Like fever.
You just need to talk.
And unko lagta hai ki psychiatrist ke paas jaane se log pagal ho gaye hain.
To this day, I would say it's a taboo sort of a thing in our country.
And it's changing.
It's changing now, yes.
We are much better off. Today I got to know that Japan had more deaths because of depression than COVID. It's so alarming that there had 2,500 deaths in 2020 because of depression. So we are much better off.
Now, yes.
Japan is worse. Like, I wonder why.
Because now I think people have started talking about it. You know, people don't feel this kind of phobia that they used to feel talking about it earlier. Like we are talking about it.
Underrated meaning? I didn't get you.
What?
Conversation is so underrated. What do you mean by that? I really want to know what is conversation is so underrated.
So under, I think he wants to say we don't give that much credit to conversations. We take conversations very lightly. Underrated thing. We should talk. We should have conversations, different conversations about so many different things.
So that's why I've started this.
Wow, amazing. मैंने पहले भी आपसे कहा था और अभी बोलूँगा मेरे को बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है देख करके कि somebody is doing this.
मार्च में I am taking a break. I need a break. Mid March I will take a break. I have to go to some places and do lot of things. So
amazing.
मेरे बहुत projects होने वाले हैं अभी बहुत कुछ होने वाला है life में. So I am looking forward to it and I hope you also grow as a photographer as a person.
Sure.
And everybody grow as a person in life and give importance to other things than just money, you know?
Yeah.
I see so many people, you know, get so stressed in life because of money making. Paisa.
Exactly.
Paisa ko agar piche pad jao ke paas paise ke it's better to just relax. Be happy and do what you like to do.
Yeah. Keep on doing what you like doing.
Do what you like. Don't do what you don't like.
Hmm.
I left my job because I didn't like that job.
Okay.
अच्छा है तुमने job ही नहीं
किया. हाँ मैं तो कभी कोई experience ही नहीं job का.
Very good.
ऐसा था कि मैं काम कुछ भी कर रहा था तो बहुत time ऐसा होता था कि जाता हूँ कहीं interview देने जाता था भाग जाता था.
I appreciate people like you who don't go for job because they want to do something of their own. It's very important.
That's true.
It needs a lot of patience and
resilience.
Lot of learning.
Lot of things. That's true.
All the best.
Narayan Shatish, good luck Vipin. Thank you so much, Narayan. Thank you so much.
Narayan is a fan.
Arre, thank you so much. And thank you so much for like giving me this opportunity. मुझे comfortable करने के लिए क्योंकि इससे पहले मुझे बड़ा डर सा लग रहा था nervousness भी थी but the way you made me comfortable was amazing. It was lovely talking to you. Truly yes that's true.
Okay bye. चलो
bye bye take care.
Come at 19 in hardcore sheet collective.
Sure. चलो bye. Bye-bye. Take care.
Bye, everyone. I'm going live again at 9 p.m. in Hardcore Sheet Collective. If you want to come, you can join me. It's Sigrid Debusschere from Brussels. I'm taking her live session. And tomorrow I have another very good inspiring person coming. Wait for it at 6 p.m. tomorrow. See you. Bye.